Welcome to iCare Central. In this video, we will talk about the anatomy of the lacrimal drainage system. The lacrimal apparatus consists of two parts, the secretory part and the drainage part. The secretory part is made up of the main lacrimal gland and the accessory lacrimal glands. The drainage part is made up of the lacrimal puncta, lacrimal canaliculi, the lacrimal sac and the nasolacrimal duct. In our previous video, we discussed the anatomy of the secretory part. In this video, we will talk about the drainage system. So the outflow of the tears begins at the lacrimal puncta. This is the right eye. On the left side is the temporal side and on the right is the nasal side. There are two puncta in each eye, an upper punctum and a lower punctum. They are located on the medial aspect of the upper and the lower eyelid margins. Each punctum is about 0.2 to 0.3 millimeters in diameter. It sits on top of an elevation known as the lacrimal papilla. The punctum lies at the apex of this elevation. The puncta are not exactly opposed to each other. The inferior punctum is approximately 0.5 mm lateral to the superior punctum and their distance from the medial canthus is 6.5 mm and 6 mm respectively. The lacrimal puncta lead to the lacrimal canaliculi. So there are two canaliculi, an upper canaliculus and a lower canaliculus. Each canaliculus has a vertical segment which is about 2 mm long and a horizontal segment which is about 8 mm long. These two segments make an angle of 90 degrees with each other. The average width of their lumen is only about 0.5 to 0.6 mm, but these canaliculi are surrounded by elastic tissue which allows them to dilate by up to 2 to 3 times their normal diameter. There are three ways by which the canaliculi can enter the lacrimal sac. In 94% of the population, the two canaliculi join together to form a common canaliculus which then enters the lacrimal sac. In about 2% of the people, there is a separate opening for each canaliculus into the lacrimal sac. While in the remaining 4%, the two canaliculi enter the sac together through a common opening without forming a common canaliculus first. Common canaliculus. It is about 2 to 5 mm in length and leads to the lacrimal sac. There is a small dilatation present in the lateral wall of the lacrimal sac, which is known as the sinus of Meyer. This is where the common canaliculus enters the lacrimal sac. Valve of Rosenmüller is located at the junction of the common canaliculus and the lacrimal sac. It prevents retrograde reflux of fluid from the sac into the canaliculi. The lacrimal sac lies in the lacrimal fossa. It is a depression present on the medial wall of the orbit, bounded anteriorly by the anterior lacrimal crest and posteriorly by the posterior lacrimal crest. The lacrimal sac is about 12.5 mm long and 2.5 mm in diameter. Its volume is 0.1 milliliters. It lies between the anterior and posterior limbs of the medial canthal ligament. This green part you can see is the medial canthal ligament. This is the anterior limb of the medial canthal ligament. The posterior limb is behind the sac, so that's why it cannot be visualized here. So the part of the sac that lies above the superior border of the medial canthal ligament is known as the fundus of the sac. It is about 3 to 5 millimeters long. And the rest of the sac that lies below the fundus is known as the body of the sac, which is about 10 mm long. The lacrimal sac is enclosed within the lacrimal fascia, which is derived from the orbital periosteum. The orbital septum attaches at the posterior lacrimal crest. This makes the sac a preseptal structure, because it lies anterior to the orbital septum. The lower part of the sac narrows and continues as the nasolacrimal duct. The nasolacrimal duct is an extension of the lacrimal sac. It is divided into two parts, the superior intraosseous part which lies in the maxillary bone, it is about 12 mm long, and the inferior membranous part which runs in the nasal mucosa and it is about 5 mm long. The diameter of the duct varies from 1 to 3 mm. The duct is not directed straight down, in fact it runs inferiorly, laterally and posteriorly to open into the inferior meatus of the nose under the inferior nasal turbinate. A mucosal valve known as Hasner's valve may be present at the opening of the duct into the inferior meatus of the nose. A little bit on the histology of the lacrimal drainage system. The canaliculi are lined by stratified squamous epithelium. The lacrimal sac and the nasolacrimal duct are lined by a double-layered epithelium. The double-layered epithelium is composed of a superficial columnar layer and a deep flattened layer of basal cells. Both layers sometimes appear as pseudostratified epithelium. So that's all for this video. Please like it and share it with your friends and colleagues if you found it useful. Please subscribe to my channel to support free education. Thank you very much.